That's just going to get bigger. And grenade. You can also see on the back here that this is, looks like the rivets are shoved over. Which is kind of odd. I don't know what's going on with this one, but it's not going in the car. I'll find another one. Alright, let's move on. Check this one out next. I tell you, it is not easy working over a tripod. So this one, due to the size, we're going to mount, instead of clamping on this side, we're going to mount inside and bring the jaws out. Let's see how that looks. Pretty good to me. Alright, back to this again, I guess. Now this one has got more rust on it than the last one. And it is one of those drippy, sniffy days. Alright. I don't see any horrible cracks on here. So, let's try method number two to clean these up. Okay, this is how my grandfather taught me to do it. This rust is too deep for sandpaper. I'll get it down a little bit. See if this one's cracked too. That crap that came out. Now, I can't in clear conscience put that other drum in that kind of engine. I wouldn't like it if somebody did that for me. Sucks, because now I gotta go find another one. Let's see what we've got. Good news is I don't see any cracks yet. I guess this one's all right. All right, I'm running upward. Still feeling bumps under the sandpaper. I And so I can see it coming around right here. A little high spot. Let's take that off. Few pits, not too bad. I don't see any cracks. It's looking pretty good. So that's the second method. This is what we got. Not bad.